Hello everyone and welcome once again to the channel. And in this video I have another project to demonstrate for you people. And so this is a Python web application that I have built using the Flask framework, and so it makes use of machine learning, five machine learning models. And so basically what this web application does is it inputs patient vitals, and based on the data set that the machine learning model has been trained upon, it makes informed decisions about whether the patient has what likelihood the patient has of contracting the disease on does the patient have the likelihood of contracting the fatal disease or not. So in this case we're looking at diabetes, cancer, liver disease, kidney disease and heart disease. So just before getting started, I would like to thank all the people that have been subscribing to the channel, that have been dropping likes. I really appreciate it, it really motivates me. And for all the people watching this video that haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe, please do like the video. It really motivates me a lot to keep creating content like this. And yeah, so this project that I'll be demonstrating, I'll be leaving the GitHub repository with the complete code, all the data sets, the complete machine learning models in the GitHub repository right here. And I'll be leaving the link to this in the description below. You can head over to the link, clone the repository, run it on your favorite editor or your favorite IDE, explore the project, make improvements upon it if you make notice any particular flaws, which I'm sure there are many. And yeah, so y'all can go ahead and always do that. And yeah, so let's allow me to demonstrate the project. So let's just hit Flask run and run this project. Just taking a little while to build here. Yeah, so now it's running at the local host. Yeah, so my default browser is Firefox. And yeah, so as you can see, there's a simple navigation bar over here that says risk assess. These are the five pages that I have: home, about us, help, login, sign up. So this is just a simple image slider, easy to use, efficient, reliable, with just a button here that redirects you to the specific pages. There's another section here that says you can assess with ease, and it says a risk assessment tool that allows for swift, efficient and smooth generation of risk assessment for your patients. It's fast, it's secure, it's reliable. Just another social connection section here. This can be omitted and it's optional. And yeah, this is just a sample footer that I have picked. And yeah, so great. So then you can head over to about us. You can see that it includes the welcome to risk assess, a risk assessment system for medical institutions to generate risk assessment for their patients. And yeah, just a simple background that I've included, nothing much over here. And yeah, so there are three main sections over here: admin, how does it work, and it makes use of machine learning models that helps generate accurate risk assessments. And this is just a simple terms and conditions page. This is not even active. Okay, this is active, but it's a really plain, just a simple plain HTML page. And if you click on generate assessment, it directly redirects you to the login page. So we'll look at that later. And login redirects you as well. So this is the help page. And yeah, so it says how to go about risk assess. It gives you the detailed steps. First you log into the system, then you select the type of disease for which you want to generate risks, then you input the patient vitals, click on submit, get the assessment, and then you can download it as a PDF. And yeah, then you can go ahead to log in. If you already have an account, then you can click on sign up. And yeah, you can enter your username, password, email, password. So this project is making use of an SQLite database, since it's very easily integrated. You can easily integrate it with your Python web applications. It's very easy to use. And yeah, since Django, in Flask, we can simply make use of the SQL Alchemy library, and which really makes life a lot easier. So we can go back home and we can go to login. And yeah, I can just enter the password as, so this is a random username and password that I've used. Yeah, so now that I've entered the credentials correctly, I've been taken to the dashboard let's call it dashboard. And so hello, let's get started with risk assess. Another simple introduction here, nothing to look at. And this section here that describes the diseases. So along with the five machine learning models that we have here, I've also created this section called disease index. So this disease index just simply includes a list of all the diseases, explains what they are, what their symptoms are. And so it's just like a directory for the patients to see about, just learn more about the disease if the system predicts a likelihood of them having the disease. So this I just felt was like an informative section that was highly needed in the website. So I did that. And yeah, so then we can head over to these for machine learning models. So for example, let's look at diabetes since it's more of a common one. There are a lot of videos and people on the internet about how you can make diabetes prediction models. Yeah, so let's start off with this one. So now you can look at these. So this is just a simple form. You enter the data here, and similarly for breast cancer, similarly for diabetes, heart disease. Yeah, these are all the values. So these are all the values that have been taken from the data set. So these are all actually the fields in the data set, and we're making use of these fields, and then the model has been trained based on these. So there are several models being used here. We're using random forest, we're using linear regression, multiple linear regression, and yeah. So and then you got kidney disease and liver disease. So let's enter our data. For example, let's go with diabetes. If we click on number of pregnancies, for example, for zero for male, obviously, but let's go ahead and select a female candidate here. So two pregnancies, for example, and let's have, so these are ideal examples that I've included here, but let's go ahead with some drastic values that are surely likely to get us a high likelihood of getting diabetes. So if we go ahead with 28, for example, for skin thickness, here I've included the data field here as well, and the unit. So that's really helpful for the patient to determine. And yeah, probably probably let's just set this down since 60 or something, and body mass index is 30. Diabetes pedigree function, just patient age 50, for example. We predict patient has a high risk of diabetes. So you see that the values that I entered those on purpose to see, because those are really high blood pressure and glucose values that are most likely to give us the output that the patient has a high risk of diabetes. So yeah, so that's what I have done there. And yeah, so you can see that this is the risk assessment page. It is a really simple page. Again, I have not put in a lot of work into this part. It just gives a simple risk assessment. You can click here, and if you click here, it's going to direct you to the disease index, which I spoke about earlier. You can go ahead to the diabetes section. You can look at the symptoms. You can learn more about the disease. And yeah, and okay, we redirect to the pre. And this download option, simply if you click on download, it's just going to download a file called diabetes assessment. Click on OK. And once it's downloaded, you can just have a look at it. And this is literally just a snapshot of the page that we just saw, downloaded in the form of a PDF. It'll directly come into your downloads. Yeah, so this is a very basic application. So we can look at another one, heart disease. So since it has a lot of fields, let's look at something that's a little lesser, maybe kidney disease. So let's have blood pressure as 120 maybe. Let's set some credible law. Let's have some reference values just in case. For example, if you go in breast cancer and we set all of these values to 4, which is really a lot, and in some cases invalid since I do not have a lot of knowledge about these values. And if you click on predict, it's going to say patient has a high risk of breast cancer as well. But if we enter all of these as 0. And if you click on predict, it says patient has a low risk of breast cancer. So you see the model works, the model works at somewhat of a good accuracy. It gives somewhat of a fair estimate about if the patient has a likelihood of contracting the disease. However, this depends a lot on the data set used, a lot on how the model has been trained, a lot on how the data has been cleaned, used. So the data set data sets have mostly been taken from various websites, majorly Kaggle. So you can have a look at those in the GitHub repository. And yeah, this is pretty much the web application, and you can use these for a lot of purposes. You can use these just for learning, and these sort of websites will help you learn a lot. And you can click on log out. After you're done, you click on log out, and yeah, that's pretty much the web application. So now let's go to the code and look at a few important things that I feel that need to be mentioned. So before we head here, let's head to the requirements.txt file and look at the things that we actually need. We need a Flask version 1.1.2. I've used that. I've used joblib, which is really important to load. Joblib is one of the really important libraries that has been used because it helps you to load the model. Then Flask Bootstrap, Flask underscore login, SQL Alchemy, these have all been used for the authentication authorization module. And WTF forms, so you can make so Flask WT forms is a really helpful library. It helps you dynamically parse the library into your HTML, so that is really helpful. Scikit-learn is another very crucial library used, and also NumPy and Pandas have played a very crucial role, since these are the standard Python libraries without which you cannot really do a lot of it. So then there's Unicorn, which is just the Python web server that we're using, and great. So app.py is the main file here that we're making use of, and now we have Flask render underscore template redirect underscore URL. These are just simply libraries imported from Flask that are helping us achieve, that are rendering the templates, helping us redirect to other pages, and yeah. And URL for is helping us attach the CSS for every HTML, yeah. And request is taking of the get, the post, all of those. So you can see I've made use of pickle as well, pickle.load. It's, and yeah, so it's loading all these model.pkl. These are all model files, and you also have secret keys here for the database. You need to be very careful with this URL, since this is going to be the database that you are going to be using. So make sure you do that really very well, and yeah, so this is pretty much it. Then these are the login form class, the registration class. This is the def index. This is for the index.html page. This is the URL that we give. This is the default one. So index.html should be loaded for the default URL when we have nothing ahead of it. If it's www.riskassess.com/about, then you show this page. If it's just www.riskassess.com, show index. Well, obviously it's not hosted right now, so it's on our local host. But if it's localhost/about, then you show this. If it's just localhost, you show index. If it's localhost/help, you show help. Further on. If it's login, then the methods that are acceptable are get and post. Make use of this. We have the sign up, the dashboard, and yeah. And so these have been annotated with this decorator here, login required. So login required says that this page cannot be accessed without logging in. If the user is not authenticated, then the user should not be able to visit this page. For example, if I go and directly enter this URL, if I directly go to this URL, for example, localhost/help, this will open, since this is not annotated with login @ login required. But since this is annotated with login required, if I directly go to localhost and write /dashboard, I will have to log in first before the dashboard.html page can open up. So that is another, these are the minute nuances that you must have in your project for it to be a wholesome and a really end-to-end project that's perfect for deployment and use. And this is the value predictor. These are really important libraries used. And this is the prediction int result == 1. Patient has high risk, please consult your doctor immediately. And doesn't, then you do this. Then this is the else condition. So this is all a very all in all very helpful to learn machine learning, get started with basic model deployment, how to use machine learning on the web. So this is something that can really help you learn a lot, get started quickly. These CSV files on the left here, these are just data files. So as you can see, the data file looks like something like this: pregnancies, glucose, blood pressure, thickness, insulin, BMI, diabetes, pedigree, function, age, outcome. We have the values here. So the model has been trained using this data set right here. And here we have the static files, we have the template files, And yeah, so that was pretty much it. So if you stay till the end of the video, then thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, please like the video, please let me know what type of videos do you want, how can I improve my videos, is there a problem with the video quality, the sound quality, please let me know. And also if you have any suggestions, please write them in the comments below. You can also send me an email at codevoid12@gmail.com. It's mentioned in the about section of my YouTube channel. So again, thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thank you.